Okay, today we're gonna start with mathematical induction and binomial theorem. Now under that, I'll start with some important points to remember regarding induction. Now in induction, we have the first principle of mathematical induction. Now the first principle says that if P of n is some mathematical statement, then I can say that if P of 1 is true and P of k is true, then P of k plus 1 is also true. The next thing is binomial theorem. Now under binomial, if A and X are real numbers and N belongs to natural numbers, then I can say X plus A the whole raised to N can be expanded as NC0 X raised to N plus NC1 X raised to N minus 1 A plus NC2 X raised to N minus 2 A square plus NC3 x raised to n minus 3 a cube. This will go on till NCn a raised to n. Now if you see over here, the power of x is going on decreasing and the power of a is going on increasing. Now there are four important points here to note down. The first one being the total number of terms is n plus 1. So this expansion has n plus 1 terms in it. The second point here would be as x goes on increasing by 1, okay, sorry, if as x goes on decreasing by 1, a goes on increasing by 1. The third point here would be, if you observe here, x reached to n is the first term. The second term, the power is n plus n minus 1 here and the power of a is 1. The total power of both x and a always sums up to n. So the total power of x and a sums up to n. The last point would be, if you see the terms NC0, NC1, NC2, these terms are called as coefficients. Now, through this general formula, there is something called as Pascal's triangle that has been derived. Okay. Now, Pascal's triangles are generally used when you have smaller values of n. So, for example, if I have n as 0. So, for n as 0, okay, anything raised to 0 is always 1. For n as 2, so this is for n equals 0. Now for n as 1, the Pascal triangle goes this way. I'll write 1, 1, that is coefficients being 1 and 1. Now for n2, it's basically x plus a the whole square. So if you know the formula of x plus a the whole square, that is x square plus 2ax plus a square, you'll see the coefficients are 1, 2 and 1. So how did I get this coefficient? Write the first number as it is towards the left. The second number, the sum of both the numbers is written in the center. Another example, when n is equal to 3, you write the first term as it is towards the left and towards the right. Now in this case, you take the sum of first two terms right in between, that is 1 plus 2 gives you 3. And again, if you see over here, 2 plus 1 also gives you 3. So if when n is equal to 3, that is basically x plus a the whole cube, you'll see there are 4 coefficients, there are 4 terms, that is x cube plus 3x square a plus 3x a square plus a cube. Same way, when I go n equals 4, again, I'll write 1 towards the left, 1 towards the right, sum of these two, 4. Sum of these two, 4, and sum of these two, 6. I can go on this way for any value of n, but as we go on increasing the value of n, the triangle becomes bigger, which makes it a little more complicated. So there are other better ways to solve sums for n, for higher values of n. Now, if you observe here, the first term, since being a single term, the sum is 1. For n equals 1, 1 plus 1, the sum gives you 2. For n equals 2, 2 plus 1, that is 3, plus 1, 4. So the sum is 4. So if you see, the sums are basically powers of 2. So the next one will be 8. This will be 16. So I can generalize this relationship saying that nc0 plus nc1 plus nc2, this will go on till ncn, the sum will be 2 raised to n. Now, when I expand, the kind of sum that you will deal with will be x plus a the whole raised to n, and you'll be asked for a specific power of x. For example, I can ask you, tell me the coefficient of x raised to 10. Okay. So how do I solve questions like these? So for questions like these, there's a general formula. The formula says tr plus 1 equals ncr x raised to n minus r ar, where r is the term that has been asked to find. For example, x raised to 10, so your r here is 10. Same way, if they ask me to find the middle term, so now to find the r plus 1 term, okay, in the expansion of x plus a the whole raised to n, the general formula goes tr plus 1 equals ncr x raised to n minus r a raised to r. So for example, if I say I want to find the 10th term, so this will be t10 equals nc9, because here there's r plus 1, whereas here you have r, so you'll have to decrease this number by 1. So nc9 x raised to n minus 9 a raised to 9. So this is the general formula to find any term. Now you'll also have a lot of questions which relate to middle term. So whenever you ask to find the middle term, first you look at what is the value of this n. If this n is even, then your middle term will be n by 2 plus 1th term. Okay. In case of n is odd, the middle term will be n plus 1 by 2 and n plus 3 by 2 term. So if you observe, when n is odd, there are two middle terms, and when n is even, there's only one middle term.